Teddy Atlas, I don't know what your opinion on it, but he likes to do these things to get attention. Mike Tyson was never a great fighter.
Mike Tyson was not a fucking badass fighter. What is he talking about?
Robert, the guy wouldn't have 70 million followers. He wouldn't be the face of boxing. Yeah. Every dog I see, every Rottweiler is named Tyson. He's the most popular. You fought him in the same cards as him, right?
Yeah, I did a couple times.
Why would Teddy Atlas say he's not an all-time great?
Yeah, because, you know, he just, He is one of the greats in boxing.
He's the Muhammad Ali of our era right now.
He is.
But you know what's crazy? It's only people in boxing that trash fighters.
Mike Tyson would knock everybody out in heavyweight division right now.
At 56 years old?
No. In his prime. In his prime, none of the guys right now would last with Tyson.
How long did Tyson Fury last?
He would get knocked out by Mike Tyson.
5 rounds, 4 rounds, 3?
I don't know, but he would knock him out.
Joshua?
Everybody. He would knock everybody out. Usyk? Mike Tyson. Usyk, yeah.
But you know what's crazy? A lot of the fighters, when I ask them, why do you get into boxing? Mike Tyson. So why would Teddy Atlas say this, Robert? Why does he need attention like that?
Maybe just to get attention, just to say something controversial, to get his name out there. Maybe, I don't know what he's doing right now. Honestly, I don't even know what he's doing. I don't know if he's training. I don't know if he's training any fighters. Or,
no.
You know, maybe he wants to get maybe one or two fighters out there. You know, like he's done before. He doesn't get a team. He doesn't have a gym where he's producing fighters like we are. So he maybe wants to get one fighter to believe in him and make a few good fights, good paydays. And, you know, like he's done a couple. You know,
He messed up with Wozniak.
Well, he did that with Wozniak.
But he messed up with
Wozniak. Okay, but he did that. He did that with Timothy Bradley. He gets one fighter once in a while, make a good payday.
Doesn't invest in them at all. One fighter.
Gets a few good paydays. You know, that's just.
Why don't you get that? Why don't you get a fighter one fight before?
I should. Look, that's the thing too. That if I only had Bam, he fought twice. He became two division champion. Then he unified and looked fucking sensational. I'll probably be nominated for Trainer of the Year, right? Yep. If I only had Bam.
I'm sure, yep.
But since I lost, Josh lost, and Falcao lost, they won't even mention my name. Even though I had Bam, even though I had Raymond, had really good wins, even though I had Santillan, had that fucking badass win, Jose Ramirez won early in the year and looked really good too. You know what I mean? But I had a couple losses, and I'd rather have that than just have one or two fighters. Yeah.
You have about 20 fighters here. They all won this year, I think.
Yeah, but you I had a couple losses too.
But everybody, he had six fights. He had four fights.
Yeah. I don't know for sure. You know, but that's just the way.
You even had exhibitions in some of your fights.
That's just the way boxing is. So you know, there's nothing we could do about it. You know, some of those, you know, pick one fighter and they focus on him and they get a few good wins and make. You know, like Teddy Atlas, maybe that's what he's looking at. Well, you know, maybe somebody calling him.
If Teddy Atlas says that Mike Tyson is not an all-time great, then I can say Teddy Atlas doesn't know anything about boxing.
He knows boxing, Ellie. He knows his boxing.
Maybe he's the worst trainer ever.
He does it to create controversy, to create people to talk about him.
Is that right?
Could be smart. Maybe not right, but could be smart.
You know Jeff Fenwick?
I know Jeff Fenwick.
He told me a funny story. Once there was a fight, and Teddy Atlas got into it with some fan, and the fan knocked him out cold.
That's what he told me.
You talk shit.
Oh, yeah, I didn't know that.
I don't know. It's just funny.
If it did happen.
By the way, Kenny Bayless retired.
Good 30 for him, man.
Years.
He had a lot of years.
How many fights have you had with him?
Huh?
How many fights did you have when he was a ref? Like,
with him?
I don't know.
Oh, a lot.
Maybe
he ref some of my fights too.
I'm sure he did.
Sure he did. You know, guys like what's the other one?
Tony Weeks?
No, he's white.
Jack Reese?
No. From Vegas.
Lane? Mills Lane?
I think he did some of my fights. I have a picture of him raising my hand up. He's still doing them right now. Now he does a lot of the replay, watches the video. He's the one that makes those decisions. Can't think of his name right now, man.
But everyone knew Kenny Bayless' style.
Kenny Bayless, yeah.
Like he would break the clinch right away.
Yeah.
What do you think?
A lot of refs have different styles. Whatever they think, and it's legal. You know, that's their style. That's like judges too. Some judges like the fighters that go forward, look for the fight. Some fighters like the boxers, the counter punchers. Some judges, maybe you have the fastest fighter scoring points, but they don't score. If you land one hard punch, they give you the round because of one punch. Some, it just depends, you know. So the refs are the same way.
I saw an interesting interview with a basketball player, Robert. He said for basketball players, it's only good to have one or two good moves. Don't have too much talent because that will confuse you. Like if you're a boxer and you do too much, you think too much. But like Nonino, they said only had a hook and he won, beat everybody.
Look, if you have a great hook or a great, then obviously, yeah, you're going to, but if you have something that good.
Like Loma.
You know, you have to have something else too. You know, you have to have something else. You have to know more, you know. There's nobody that becomes a world champion with only one punch and nothing else, you know. The only one that I could think that might be probably Wilder, his fucking right hand, but never really showed anything else. Never
42
showed,
knockouts, you know, and yeah, 42 showed, wins, yeah.
A lot more. 41. You know, he dropped Fury with a left hook, remember? Almost had him out. So he had power in both hands, not just the right hand. So, you know, I think everybody, he only has the left hook. No, there's a lot more in there. Maybe he lands that hook perfect and it's very comfortable doing it, but he's got a lot more.
But do you think a fighter should have like two or three basic things that he should not think too much, not look for?
Perfect example is Mikey. Mikey, very basic. You know, effective, explosive 1-2, you know, very effective. You know, didn't do much other stuff. But if he had, he was never forced to, but he could have fought a fight where he has to go forward and make maybe look for the, you know, become a brawler, and he would have been successful too.
Because he knew how to do it. He did it in the gym many times.
He did it, yeah, I remember with my dad.
He did it in the gym many times.
Another day here at the office. New Year, January 1st, Big G. The first of the year. How do you say first of the year in Spanish?
El primero del año.
El primero de año, right today.